Tryndamere is the muscly fighter known for his strength as well as running you down with right clicks. In the lore, we get an image of a huge Chad hunting monsters in the Freljord for his food. And funnily enough, this insane Tryndamere player is obsessed with a full carnivore diet. And when I checked out his Discord, I found that he thinks he should drink blood more often. So that's interesting. I have never seen a one trick so dedicated to their champion. Except where Tryndamere has his fury, this guy is actually just quite nice and positive. In season 11, he has climbed to Grandmaster with a new, fun Tryndamere mid lane build. Our player is named Yasuki. Yasuki started playing League in season 2, just playing random things like AP Ezreal, getting into Silver. In season 3, he could never just stick with the champion, playing over 80 different champions over the course of the season, playing solidly for the last 36 hours of the season, fueled by caffeine, and he just scraped his way into Platinum. Back in season 4, he discovered Tryndamere top, falling in love, and climbing all the way up to Diamond for the first time. In season 5, he kept grinding away on Tryndamere, improving his knowledge, pushing up through Diamond. Season 6, he peaked in Diamond 2, but he was still unable to get above it with Tryndamere top lane. In season 7, he took a break to try some other roles, and learn more about the game, especially mid lane. He would always do well on Tryndamere top, but whenever he was autofilled or didn't get his main role, he of course didn't know what to play, so he thought he would try to make Tryndamere mid lane work, to give him a good second option. Back then, it was the old rune system, and he found Storm Raider's Surge, which he started testing out on Tryndamere mid. This rune completely stopped Tryndamere getting kited, and changed his game, hitting Diamond 1 for the first time. He had always been told that Tryndamere was a top lane champion, but as soon as he swapped, he broke his hard-stuck streak. In Season 8, this build brought him all the way to Masters for the first time. With Season 9 came the rune's rework, and he was forced to adapt, but Riot added basically the exact same Keystone rune again, in Phase Rush, so mid lane Tryndamere was fine, and he climbed up to Grandmaster. Same thing in Season 10, and then the item rework happened. Tryndamere changed. Tiamat, one of his core items, was basically deleted. He tried any build he could think of. Crit builds, ability haste builds, tank builds, nothing worked. On stream, while he was struggling to climb, a viewer suggested something. Yasuki knew the viewer was a gold player, so he wasn't too excited about the recommendation, but he thought about it for a couple of days, and decided to at least give it a try. This new build clicked. It fit his playstyle perfectly, and he went all the way up to a new peak rank. This player's new build is one of the most fun I have ever found. It is Phase Rush Tryndamere. Tryndamere does not need more damage from his runes. His main issue is not being able to stay on top of people to auto-attack them. This rune fixes that, giving Tryndamere so much movement speed to stay on top of enemies. Oh, and it even has a bonus synergy with Tryndamere W, the slow. This acts as one of the spell hits, so you can do a combo of long-range W into an E and then auto-attack to activate the movement speed. Enemies are slowed by the W and they cannot react to your new movement speed, making you an even bigger threat. Stridebreaker is also an item that is absolutely perfect for Tryndamere, with an extra dash to jump on squishies, and a huge slow that once again enables Tryndamere's damage. Yasuki thinks the changes to this item on the new patch don't really affect Tryndamere, as he often stacks his W slow with the Stridebreaker, so the nerf doesn't matter, and the extra range may even make it a buff for Tryndamere. You might think the rune sounds good, the item sounds good, but how can Tryndamere handle laning in mid lane? What about poke mages, assassins, or even AD carries? Won't he just get destroyed? Yasuki has a solution to this to make sure he leaves laning phase in a good spot. The first part of this is starting boots. This seems like a troll, but it really helps Tryndamere get to the fast power spike of Ionian Boots. As a champ with no mana costs and only cooldowns to cap his abilities, they are a vital first item. 900 gold for about 17% cooldown reduction is crazy. Now at level 1, Yasuki takes E. The spin is the mobility of the champion, the most important ability for going in and getting out. Yasuki focuses on grabbing CS where he can, trying to get a level 2 advantage by controlling the wave and threatening an all-in with your ignite. Tryndamere mid is not a familiar matchup, so enemies don't know how much they can pressure you, which gives Yasuki free farm at level 1. At level 2, Yasuki's first big strategy starts. Taking Q, he shoves the wave in, using his E, fast, and then autoing to get to full fury. He then begins to invade the enemy jungler. This level 2 is so smart, if the enemy jungler started red and is full clearing, or started blue, then at this time, he should be at the raptors, dealing with the large camp. So when Tryndamere runs over, he has a 1v1 with an ignite advantage and a full fury bar for damage, with an E now off cooldown, ready to jump on the jungler. This is such a good idea because it messes with the enemy jungler's early game plan. No jungler is expecting an invade here, so they'll be surprised, and they'll be forced to make a new decision. They can either stay and fight to hope their mid laner helps in time, or flash away and run. This is not a decision any high elo player has to make level 2 in their jungle most games, so it puts a ton of pressure on them, and if they mess up, they die, and from there Yasuki is in charge of their jungle. Skipping ahead a bit, to when buffs respawn around level 6, Yasuki does the exact same thing, pushes mid and walks into the enemy jungle, going to one of the buffs. He wants to contest it. This is really easy to track. When your jungler's buff is coming up, you know that the enemies will be up at around a similar time, or if you've got vision of it at any time, Riot just tells you when it's coming up. So Yasuki abuses this free information for a free buff, stealing resources from the enemy jungler. And since mid laners always have a 1 or 2 level lead on a jungler, he can go for a free kill here too. It's a really simple strategy that Riot have handed to him. It is surprising it doesn't happen more in solo queue. Back to laning, level 3, Yasuki takes his W, farming up, his next power spike is level 6. Level 4 and 5 he can get kills, in a very specific situation. He avoids poke, waiting for the enemy to use their key ability, whether it's a CC or a dash. It means Tryndamere can go in and not be stopped. He uses his phase rush combo of W to slow, then E auto attack. This instantly pops phase rush, which lets him instantly stick on them, giving them no options. With an ignite and more auto attacks, he finishes off the kill. Yasuki even uses his combo to escape ganks, becoming a pressure sponge, baiting enemies to come to his lane, then quickly proccing phase rush, and sprinting away before they can even touch him. At level 6, Yasuki gets his ultimate. At level 5, he spins forward, killing the last minion with his E, to surprise the enemy, who had no idea he was about to unlock his invulnerability. Enemies assume he is being too aggressive, so they're baited in, which leaves them no escape from his damage once he gets the safety of level 6. This works in Diamond, in Master, and in Grandmaster, so I think 99% of players will be able to get a kill with this trick. In lane, if he ever has his ultimate up, he goes for an all-in. He never bases when there is a chance to at least steal a summoner spell. Get full fury, use the same phase rush combo, and go for it, running away at light speed if it is unsuccessful. But what if you're in a really hard laning phase, and none of this is relevant, because you're just being poked down by a Lucian? Yasuki has some special strategies to make these counters easier to deal with. Of course, Lucian is higher range than Tryndamere, and even has mobility to run away, so Yasuki decided to look for a window where he is more even. Level 1, E-ing forwards immediately, and even igniting during the all-in at level 1, gives Tryndamere a possible kill, as well as some safety for the rest of the lane. Even if you don't get the kill, the enemy is poked down, and also, there is a legitimate 0% chance you need that ignite before it comes back up. You don't have an advantage in this lane at level 2, not at level 3, level 4, or level 5, and by the time you get an advantage at level 6, the ignite is back up again, so worst case, you lose nothing and tilt the enemy mid laner. Levels 1 to 6 in a poke lane are hard. Tryndamere has to accept any CS he can get, and uses Q Fury, mostly as a healing tool when possible. At level 6, the matchup evens up, and Tryndamere has one play to get an advantage. Bait their dash, spin in and surprise them, sticking on them with phase rush. In hard matchups, it's even more important to steal buffs. If you are AFK in lane waiting for CS, everyone else in the game is progressing ahead of you. But if you go and steal one of the enemy jungler's buffs when it spawns, you pass that disadvantage onto the enemy jungler. Matchups like this are hell early game, but only get easier and easier as the game goes on. Once you hit mid game, there is no way for Tryndamere to lose this fight, because the enemy just cannot run away from his damage. I watched so many replays that looked doomed in lane. And then at level 10, Yasuki just 1v1s them, and the matchup completely turns. From here, Yasuki gets into mid game, wanting to side lane and vacuum up any farm he can find. Tryndamere is already very scary for any champion to 1v1, so splitting gives a free lane of farm for Yasuki to pressure, and he can then rotate to any objective. Often, that objective is him stealing more camps from either jungler. Yasuki needs two items before he wants to join fights, so get the wave, push it in with Stridebreaker, spin into the jungle to get some more gold, then spin back to lane to get more waves. Repeat. Sometimes Yasuki gives up part of a wave because stealing camps are more important, because they also steal resources from the enemies. With a low cooldown on his E and face rush, he is almost not worth ganking. He never pushes too far, using his years of practice to judge where enemies are, based on who is in vision. If he has no information, he knows he needs to back up or he will die. Does he see 4 people mid? It's safe to push up, maybe go for a 1v1. 5 people mid? Hit that tower as soon as he can. If he is behind, he keeps this strategy going for as long as he can, until he can get even in items. But it's not all farming and splitting. Side lane on Tryndamere absorbs one enemy to answer him at all times, and that gives him the opportunity to leave the lane, flanking, to get a 5v4 fight. If the enemy top laner matches you and TP's in, the fight might already be won, or he could just backs up and does it again after pushing in another wave. This is where the team fights start. If you're ahead, you want to be diving and killing carries in the team fights. If you're behind, you can still kill carries, but your main goal is making enemies waste their resources on you. If the enemies use all of their resources on a Tryndamere who's behind, it makes it so much easier for the rest of your team to win the fight, because they won't have to deal with the important CC that gets used on you. Here's a perfect teamfight example. Before the fight, Yasuki's hitting minions to keep his fury fully stacked. It's an ideal situation to be in before a fight. He then joins the fight using his W to ensure their team stays split up. He uses Stridebreaker to trap Fiora in the frontline, killing her in a 3v1. Instantly he flashes onto Lucian, the enemy's main damage dealer. He dives and kills him in 2 hits. The enemy Nico is dead dead to his team, so Yasuki instead finds his next priority target, another squishy, Seraphine, which he again chases down and finishes off, staying alive with his Q. Team fighting is simple. Carries are always your main target. Stride Breaker and Phase Rush lets you get on them, sticking on them until you're too low and you have to leave, then spin away and try and survive. You're one big distraction with loads of damage. The other obvious play is just to 1v1 the enemy in the side lane, which is what Tryndamere does best. The amount of slows and movement speed Yasuki has makes it a breeze to chase people down in the long side lanes, through any escapes or flashes they have. Yasuki sometimes even takes a 1v1, not to actually get a kill, but to bait the enemy team to rotate over, escaping with Phase Rush and wasting enemies' time so that his team can pressure the other side of the map, for example start a Baron. You can see why Yasuki loves this champion. The movement speed combined with the spins and the ultimate allow him to take incredibly aggressive plays that no other champion could make, even when he's behind. He bans Zoe every game, the sleep is insane against Tryndamere ult in fights, and laning against her once again is straight uphill that cannot be avoided. For his build, he starts Boots, Rejuvenation Bead and Potion, the extra movement speed and sustain, getting him to Ionian Boots very fast. Sometimes he even sells the Rejuvenation Bead to get them faster, because it is one of the highest gold efficiency items to sell in the game. First item is Stride Breaker, second item Phantom Dancer for crit and more movement speed. These give you your two core items that you can start to win fights with. Also, Stride Breaker's mythic passive gives even more movement speed to stick on enemies, which Yasuki believes is the strongest stat in the game. Third, if he wants crit, then he's going Infinity Edge, but you can also go Bloodthirster for extra lifesteal and survivability, or Mortal Reminder third for anti-healing. Ravidus Hydra is also a great item. He goes the same runes every game no matter what, not even taking magic resist against AP champions. The Phase Rush is a classic, and then Tenacity is super important to stop Tryndamere's worst enemy, CC. I am testing this out right now on my stream at twitch.tv/happychimenoises, and thank you to Yasuki for all the help. Please check out his Twitch stream and YouTube channel as well, links in the description. 99% of the information in this video is right from his brain, and he was incredibly helpful in making this video. Thanks so much for watching, see you next time.